it, girl! What time is it? I think it's time for a little pop. That's just my opinion. Yes, it was time for a little pop. What am I going to do today? I got no idea until I went and checked the mail. And you know how you get the junk mail in all the time. It just on sale, that on sale. And this one is from Hack in the Jack. And it said they got this new burger with bacon and stuff, you know, and the pictures on the page ain't nothing like, that's dolled up, in other words. When you get the real deal, it ain't like that. So I got to thinking, boy, I bet I can do something better than that. Let's experiment with something we ain't never done before. Down here in, down the bayou here at JB Studios. Let's try to make us, how you call it? A Catfish cheeseburger with fried green tomatoes. And I saved some of those bacon creamed onion potatoes. And we'll have some of them too. So, cacklefish, what is that? What's a cackle fruit? You know what a fish is. You know what a burger is. You know what a tomato is. Think about it. Maybe we'll put some bacon on them too. That'd be fine. Okay, to start this out, I've got a couple thin pieces of bacon in here. And we need this bacon grease and the bacon too. Let's go on and chunk us some toes of garlic in there just for fun. Let's be creative today. It's creative day in South Louisiana. Once your bacon is crisp, go ahead and get it out and put it on a little pan. And garlic on a pan and look in there. Oh yum, that's some good looking stuff right there. Now watch what we're gonna do. Now let's keep our bacon and garlic warm, but we need about a half an inch total. That's close. A Earl in the pan, because I've got some green tomatoes here that have been breaded, and they're from Pick Sweet, and it said frozen fresh from the farm. Oh, ain't that pretty. Now let's open the bag, and it's not non-union. It opened right up. Look at that. So we're gonna fry a couple of them in this bacon flavored Earl. How about that? Oh, we got to bring it up to temp. I just poured that oil in there. Let that Earl get hot again. Now, oil's up to 350, 352, 355. And let's drop our little green tomatoes in there and fry them a couple minutes on each side. Cool, huh? Now, let's remove them from the pan carefully and try not to remove any of the breading like I did. See, this one's loose. So is this one. And we're gonna keep these warm in the oven. Like I already said. Now what we're gonna do is strain off the good stuff and wipe out the bottom of this nonstick pan because we want to use that bacon oil to fry the catfish in. Cool, huh? So let's tilt our pan and get the oil without the burn stuff, or as little as you can. And strain it off into something heat resistant because this oil's hot. So we're gonna continue with this and we're gonna wipe this pan down. So use a paper towel and clean your pan out. After you give it a little bath in the sink. Okay? You can pour your strained oil back in there. Now, got some Zatarain's New Orleans style fish fry seafood breading mix. This is Southern Crispy. You could just mix you some cornmeal and flour, about half and half, and then season it to taste. That's basically what this is, with extra garlic powder. So get your catfish fillet out of here. It's all thawed out in dyed water, and don't dry it off. Now if you want, look over here, boy. If you want a thicker coating on this catfish, dunk it in milk and egg first. But I don't really want a thick coating on it, because I'm going to eat this on bread. And we don't need all that extra breading. We'll just go ahead and give it a nice little coating of this Zatarain seasoned fish fry mix. And it's plenty good enough right there. Now we're going to put it in that pan with the hot Earl, the bacon flavored Earl, bacon garlic flavored Earl, and cook it till it's done. Ain't nothing hard about this. We ain't building nuclear submarines and rocket ships and all that crap. Okay? It's going to be plenty good, just like that. Yum. With the Earl, drop your catfish in there. You see the little places you missed? Put you some more seasoning or coating on them. Now, let that cook till it's done. Tony, you gotta flip it naturally. We'll do that in a minute. It ain't ready to flip yet. Now let's flip her. Yeah. Looks wonderful. Flip her over. Just like that. Let it finish on the second side. You see down there, boy? Look here. Well, let's do the same thing with this. Let's keep it warm until we're ready to serve it. Ooh, hotsy, hotsy, totsy. We'll go ahead and do the same thing with the oil again. We're going to use it for something else. What you going to do with that, JP? Pay attention, boy. So once again, straining out the oil. And we need some of it. We don't need too much of it. Just a bit. What you gonna do with that? Uh-oh. If he got something up his sleeve now. Right, so look up at Lionheart Spices, set to try some of his smoked herb and garlic on beef. And that's what I'm gonna do. There was a piece of the little seal up in there. So we're gonna distribute some on this burger. And see how it comes out. Normally, I only like salt and pepper. That's it. I'm kind of a purist like that. That's the other hand. This is the hand dirty. My clean hand. And it smells really good. So let me do both sides. And being as I'm not cooking outside, we're cooking inside in a skillet. Let's go try this out. So I'm gonna go ahead, dump that burger in there, just like that. And let it form a little crust. I like a crust on a burger. Think of it as a bark. The external part that gets crisp. And yeah, the herbs are gonna brown and possibly burn a little bit. It's gonna be okay. Just like on a prime rib, it's okay to do this, unlike what some folks believe. So now let's have a little bit of fun. Let's put a little pat of butter in here. Try not to fry your fingers, JB. That ain't no fun at all. Let's take this couple hamburger buns. Give them a little butter on top, a little butter on bottom, and have a sacrificial piece to make a Mac Dick, whatever, Mickey Mackey D, do too. Now when that thing and the burger in the back starts bleeding a little bit out the top, we're gonna flip it. Go ahead and get these out of there, and we're gonna finish them in a minute. I just wanted to get a little bit of butter in the pan. And make us a Parmesan crisp. Parmesan cheese, pour it in your pan. Get you another little pile over here. Pour it in the pan. We'll have this with a salad, if I remember to cut lettuce up. Okay. Watch what happens. Now let's take our crusty burger out of the pan. Yum. So now let's take us the cackle fruit part of this and put it in this pan with some butter. You know, I really like cackle fruit, fried cackle fruit with a crispy edge around it. Some people don't. Some people do. And I'm one that do. So salt it. And pepper it. And if you fry it in bacon grease, like Ms. JB just said, it'll do that even better. Duck fat, chicken fat also works. No, look, There's a chicken foot in there. Oh, the baby chicken getting all fried up. Got me a little salad wedge right here. And I'll probably put some kind of dressing on it. I don't know. I got some French. I may put that or some Italian or the other how you call it kind. It don't really matter. You put your favorite on there. Put your favorite dressing on and eat. I like Frenchies. I like ranch too. Now, with a Parmesan crisp on top. Yum. This Villa's Catfish Burger. Got two burger bottom buns. You can do it on po' boy bread. Some fried green tomatoes. Some, what is that? Look like bacon over there. More bacon. Where the beef? Where's the damn beef? That's what I'm talking about. How about them garlic pieces? Oh yeah, baby. Get them on there too. Some little cooked garlic pieces. Get them all over there. A little piece of bacon for the chef. Fried green tomato. All built up. You want some nice German pepper mustard on there? Put it on there too. Yum. Put that right on top. Mountain man sandwich. Now, how you like that? With some of my famous cream tater. Yumness. See that? So how you eat this? Use a damn knife and fork, boy. What's wrong with you? Nice lettuce wedge. With Parmesan cheese chip. Never mind. Use croutons if you want. Don't need all that. Cacklefish in a pan. Nah, it's a catfish fillet, boy. Look at that propping job I done there. Now, JB, you think you got enough sauce on that lettuce or dressing? Bull. Yum. The cheese will melt in the second the burger's hot. And these potatoes, man, that's garlic. They're hot with garlic. Oh, yum. Bacon, green onion, and yumness. And that German, pepper of German mustard oozing out right there on top. Pick that boy up and eat it like a man, son. Let's see you do that. But use a fork on the lettuce. This is a limited edition. And if it goes over well, they'll keep making it. They should go over well. I have to have that too. Just for some extra crunch and yum. Yum. More yum. Good Lord, I love this. This was fine, fine eating, boy. Now you buy your zaps there online. All right, have fun.